And as we discussed earlier with the Philippine Chamber of Commerce and Industry in Iloilo, the group is calling on government to come up with long-term solutions to the power woes plaguing the Visayas region.
Joining us now to talk about that is Energy Secretary Rafael Lutilia. Good evening, Sec Popo. Back in Business Outlook again, I see.
Hi, Salve and Ron. I'm happy to be with you, but not under these circumstances. I feel the pain of Iloilo and the rest of Panay, and for a while even parts of Negros because of these power interruptions. But it's good to point out that we were hoping that when the transmission system was privatized way back in 2009, that the private sector would have more connectivity with the rest of private sector, and therefore would make sure that the transmission services would perform at their very best. And that's why I'm rather disappointed. Remember last time when we talked before New Year, that I was talking a lot about the transmission system.
Yeah.
And this incident shows you why that is very important, because we need that to deliver the power to where they are needed. And in this particular case, listening this morning to the report of the Independent Electricity Market Operator, the IMAP, they pointed out that there was a two-hour window of opportunity for the NGCP as systems operator to come in and prevent the system from collapsing. But there was no manual load dropping that was resorted to by NGCP during that two-hour period. And so I cannot, we need, as Engineer Wu from the PCCI Iloilo was saying, there is need for transparency, because unless we get to identify the root cause of the problem, then we will not be able to address the problem at all. And looking back at what happened less than a year ago in April of 2023, when the same island-wide blackout happened in Panay, I take a look at the reports of NGCP at the time, and they pointed out a number of things. One, they were relying on the power from the other islands, and for that to finish the Panay Negros Cebu interconnection by August of 2023. And that is reflected in the report to DOE, which was transmitted to the president, no less, because the president is very much concerned about the adequacy of supply, not only in Luzon, but in the rest of the Visayas, including Panay. And they let me just quote here that in terms of adequacy of generating capacity, the Visayas grid has sufficient amount of available capacity, including power sharing with Luzon, to accommodate its system demand. The additional import from the Mindanao grid to the Mindanao-Visayas high voltage interconnection will also enhance the operating margin in the Visayas for its full operations. So this assumes that the Mindanao-Visayas interconnection and the Panay-Negros-Cebu interconnection would be implemented on time. And they were not. We are now in January, and they promised this in August, and we will see the Mindanao interconnection hopefully to be finished by January 25.
Mr. Secretary,
these are the things that I want to emphasize, that we all need to be accountable, responsible, and transparent to our people.
For this situation, Mayor Jerry Treñas of Iloilo hit the NGCP. Are they the ones solely to blame for this incident, and should they be held accountable?
To me, the main accountability is with them, because it is NGCP that is tasked with maintaining the stability of the grid. And stability means what? Being able to proactively respond if there is going to be a generation plant that suddenly comes that suddenly breaks down. Mm-hmm. This occurs every now and then. But I have to commend our distribution utilities for responding, the electric co-ops and the distribution utilities for responding by making sure that those facilities that require power, particularly hospitals, blood banks, mm-hmm. were given the first priority as far as power distribution is concerned. So as far as that is concerned, I really have to commend them. As for the generators, the six plants mm-hmm. tripping simultaneously cannot just be an isolated problem yeah. of one generator. Uh-huh. So it does. We have to look at it from a system standpoint. And so let's work together on all of these.
Yes, Sec Popo, just to clarify, this could have been prevented.
It is preventable because within that two-hour window of opportunity that the independent electricity market operator has pointed out, NGCP could have called on the distribution utilities in Panay, call up manually the electric cooperatives and ask them to reduce their load. Mm-hmm. And they can do that. You don't wait for the entire system to collapse. Mm-hmm. Because when the entire system to collapse, in order to put on the generators again online, mm-hmm. takes time. Last time it took us 3 days. Now it's taking us again 3 days. Now on the positive side, the ramp up of the Concepcion pump Concepcion generation plant in Iloilo is proceeding well at this time, and hopefully let's hope and pray that everything will go well so that by tonight they can start mm-hmm. to synchronize with the entire system. But we cannot afford these costly interruptions. The other point that Engineer Wu was pointing out is the unique nature of Panay being at the tail end of a broken rosary. Right. Because the power comes all the way from Leyte, goes to Cebu, Cebu to Negros, Negros to Panay. Mm-hmm. And since Panay is not gifted with generation plants from, let's say, large dams, mm-hmm. we have to rely on coal-fired power plants, on diesel plants, and now with more renewables. And that's the other appeal that I have for our local governments and communities in Panay, that we help the newer power plants to come on stream. Mm-hmm. Yeah, by facilitating the permitting systems, mm-hmm. because at the end of the day, once these plants are put up, they will benefit our people. They will be the ones to power the economic activities that are needed by our people in Panay. And I believe in the resiliency, mm-hmm. not only of Ilonggos, but of Antiqueños like mm-hmm. myself, and of the people of Aklan and Capiz, and of Negros. We will overcome this particular obstacle, but we need everyone on board.
Sec Popo, just one last final quick question from me. What is the implication now for NGCP, and how do you make sure that they are now accountable and this will not happen again?
Well, Mayor Jerry Treñas has called for Congress to look into the matter. As you know, the matter about the franchise is a congressional power. It is not lodged with me, nor with the president, but with Congress. And therefore, Congress has the plenary authority to inquire into how the system has performed. But even without that, I think that as a member of the private sector, NGCP should put the welfare of the people and of the business sector as its topmost priority. At the end of the day, if there is more power, then there is more business for NGCP. And would mean more development for the people, more jobs and business opportunities for all.
Thank you so much, Sec Popo. Praying for the people of Western Visayas.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mr. Secretary.
And thank you, Albert.